Hey yo, what is going on, viewers of the tube? My name is Tyler, and welcome to the channel that brings you the content that could be considered more high stakes than the final poker scene in the movie Rounders.
I bet it. Well, you're right, Teddy, the ace didn't help me. I flopped the nut straight.
And just like Matt Damon, we like to slow play it. You know the flop. It's time for Chico Crypto. Speaking of stakes, in today's episode, we're going to be breaking down Ethereum, which will be switching to a proof of stake beacon chain in the coming months. Yes, Ethereum proof of stake is coming, which will include some big changes, especially if you hold a good stack of Ethereum. So the first thing we need to watch out for regarding ETH proof of stake is another network upgrade codenamed Ethereum Istanbul. This comes in the form of a hard fork and is the 8th improvement fork in Ethereum's history. 6 improvement proposals have been accepted, and they are all preparing Ethereum for 2.0 and staking. Upgrades with Istanbul will align the cost of opcodes with their computational costs, resulting in greater DDoS resilience. Layer 2 solutions based on SNARKs and STARKs will be faster and cheaper, and it will allow for smart contracts to have more creative functions through re-entry locks and same contract multi-send. Istanbul was set to go live on the Ethereum testnets this month, and it needs to be observed on one or more testnet before it's upgraded to the mainnet. Ropsten was already upgraded earlier this month. Did it go down without a hitch? Of course not. It came earlier than expected on October 2nd due to faster block confirmation times, and it caused a chain split because a large majority of the miners did not upgrade to the latest hardware. Is this worrisome? Well, last year around the same time in October with the last upgrade, Constantinople, a chain split happened as miners once again failed to upgrade their software. Lazy miners, but with Constantinople, the split only lasted a few hours. This Istanbul testnet fork, which began on September 30th, has not resolved itself quickly, for this was not because of a bug like Constantinople, but because this is preparing the main proof of work chain for the launch of something the miners do not like, proof of stake. Thus, some miners are showing their dislike and still mining the legacy Ropsten testnet. Although it's once again a matter of switch or get left behind, from a post on Reddit on the Ropsten test network, a person posted, it's blazingly fast. Now, the main chain of Ethereum needs this Istanbul upgrade fully live and functioning before the launch of the Beacon Chain's mainnet, which is slated to go live before the end of 2019, according to Ethereum's roadmap. Now, the testnet of the Beacon Chain has been live since May of this year. Prismatic Labs was the first client testnet launched as Prism F2, but since, 6 more have been developed by Pegasus, Harmony, Trinity F Client, Chainsafe Systems, Status's Nimbus, and finally Sigma Prime. And back in mid-September, the testnet clients interoperated and communicated with each other, signaling a full mainnet phase 0 beacon chain on the horizon. Then on October 5th, the Ethereum 2.0 staking deposit contract had finished formal verification. Many thought the beacon chain mainnet might be announced at DevCon, but that passed and no official date has been announced. Although staking is coming and the Chico army is going to be prepared to take advantage of the early rewards. So if you're going to want to stake Ethereum on the mainnet when it goes live on day 1, 32 Ethereum is a requirement if you want to stake yourself. If you want to stake yourself, the next thing you should be doing is playing around with one of the testnet clients I mentioned above. Now publicly there is only one beacon chain testnet which you can easily join, unless you are a developer and can get into the others' GitHubs. This is Prismatic Labs' Sapphire testnet, and it is the largest with over 300 validators. They have instructions on how to set up their testnet and have a Discord or Gitter channel if you have any questions. So learning about the Beacon Chain testnet is a must in preparation, but also, as I'm sure most of you watching this channel are non-developers, is running a full Ethereum node. Yes, for staking on the mainnet, a requirement will be running a full Ethereum node, at least initially. I've included documentation for setting up a full node on the Ethereum mainnet if anyone is interested in getting prepared. Now, the most important thing to do as a node operator for the beacon chain is to ensure uptime, as you can be penalized if your node or server goes down and isn't able to secure the blockchain. Old Vitalik gave us some insight into what will be acceptable uptime for the nodes.
Like the way that I interpret staking is that staking is kind of like being like part of the reserve army. So like you don't have to go to battle, you can stay at home. But you know, if a war happens, then you know, yes, you get drafted and you have to go to the field. But normally wars don't happen. So it's like that kind of relationship where if an emergency happens, you have to really make sure that you're online to be able to kind of defend against it. But otherwise, you know, online 2/3 of the time, whatever, and you'll be okay.
So it looks like 2/3 of the time will be acceptable with no penalty, unless the blockchain is getting attacked and all nodes are needed. Now, keeping a node or server online has various faucets, including hacker protections, software updates, firewalls, and more. Basically, setting up a secure server. And as IT pros know, this requires long-term and constant effort. That is why many people are looking to move their nodes to the cloud, AWS, Microsoft, and more, because of their guaranteed uptimes and protections. I've included documentation in the description for setting up a full Ethereum node remotely in the cloud. But if you want to do it at home, as this is the most decentralized you can get, Vitalik gave some insight into hardware requirements right out the gate. For a 32 Ethereum validator node, a standard laptop will work. At 100 Ethereum, you will need a high-end desktop computer. And in the thousands of Ethereum, you will need a server rack. Eventually, these requirements will go down, as proof of stake has been proven to be lightweight, as the Nimbus testnet ran on a Raspberry Pi 3B with 128 Ethereum during a presentation at DevCon. So I bet some of you watching are like, well shit, what am I gonna do for staking? I don't wanna run a full node, I just wanna earn the rewards. Well, there will be options for you. There will be staking pools in many forms coming where you send your Ethereum to them and it is pooled together and they run the server, guaranteeing its uptime and your payment of rewards. I'm sure there will be centralized forms coming out, but honestly, who's going to send 32 Ethereum worth over $5,500 free and clear and trust that entity with it? So the only centralized solutions I see coming out that will work is from big names like Coinbase or big custodians like Fidelity. But these will definitely take some time to build and are centralized. If only there was a decentralized staking pool option. Well there is, and it's going to be ready for the Beacon Chain launch. This is called Rocketpool, and it's aligning interests of those who want to stake but not run a node with those who want to run a node and generate a higher return on their own staked Ethereum during the process. Rocketpool began work on this in late 2016 when the specs of the new proof of stake consensus were released, and Rocketpool 2 version 1 beta launched on September 24th, and you can try it out right now. Also, Rocketpool has some great guides for those who want to get started staking, or even running an Ethereum staking smart node through Rocketpool. All of this is included in the description. There is a token involved with Rocketpool, and it's very, very much under the radar. Only a $4 million market cap, small supply, and not listed on any exchanges, as a team hasn't been pushing for that until the product is live. Digging into their white paper on the function of RPL token, the token is required if you wish to act as a node operator, and not required for users to stake Ether in the Rocketpool staking network. And the number of RPL required by node operators is based on network utilization. In the beginning, a high amount per Ethereum, but as the network grows, this number goes down. Thus, there will be demand for RPL, especially if node operators can earn a higher stake percentage through their pool. Well, viewers, the stakes are being raised. Ethereum is going through a mass change, and things are going to really heat up in the coming months. But staking is coming for more than just Ethereum, but also the DeFi projects built on Ethereum. Tune in tomorrow as we go through Chainlinks, ZeroX's, and iExec's upcoming staking token contracts. Because just like Ethereum, these projects are holding a nut straight draw. Cheers. I'll see you next time.